glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. We've seen some thrillers in the MAC championship game over the years. 2012 season, two teams were playing for what turned out to be a spot in a BCS game. The Mid-American Conference championship game is coming up. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football Pregame Show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the half.
Let's head down to the coin toss now. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Nice run to the outside. Central Michigan's got a guy that statistically is leading the conference right now, and he has got the attention of everybody in the country, including the coordinators. From their own 43-yard line, second down. Bring him down around the 46-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of three.
That's the senior safety that made that tackle. Great job of providing run support from the secondary.
And he's tackled at about the 45.
When you're running the ball for big chunks of yards like that, you've got something working.
The 45-yard line. First down. Makes the first down catch. And they make the stop around the 31-yard line.
This receiving corps runs some great routes. And that last play was an example of that. As a defender, it can be tough to match up sometimes.
First and 10. Ball on the 31-yard line. He's taken down at about the 29-yard line. Richardson gains around 2 yards there on the option.
And that's the safety who stepped up to make that tackle.
For a nice game. Here's third down, 4 yards to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. Well, the last drive was good for three, but I'm sure in this one they'll be looking to double that. Central Michigan holds a field goal lead. The halfback with a carry. Tackle made at the 30. And the linebacker comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
From their own 30-yard line, it's second down. Going deep, lays it out there. Central Michigan's got a guy behind center that can really do it all, Herbie. I mean, he's a dual threat. He can hurt you with his feet and his arm. With this guy, it's PYP. Pick your poison.
Three down, three down. Check it.
the 49-yard line.
The pass was a little bit high, but this kid had no trouble adjusting and making a great play.
From their own 49-yard line, first down, empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Slings it out there, incomplete.
Overthrew his man, but boy, did he have some heat on him. He just needs to put a little bit more touch on that pass.
That makes it second and ten.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Tries to fit it in there, and it'll be intercepted. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. He's to the 40. He's tackled right around the 44-yard line. From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. Stopped behind the line.
The option can be really tough to defend. At that time, it was well played by the defense. Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. Brought down at the 46-yard line. Wow, a long game, but still not enough for the first.
Well, the offense hurt themselves by digging themselves into a hole on first and second down, so the defense didn't really have to put too much thought in how to defend on that third down.
This defense not wanting to give an inch here. Tackled after a decent pickup. And they convert for the first down.
And Brad, the credit here needs to go to the offensive line. They did a great job of opening up a running lane for the back.
From the 42-yard line. First down. And he can't get away from the pressure.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
They come out on an empty backfield. He is drilled at the 27-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 27. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun.
These guys, especially in the secondary, really get after it and can make life hard for the play callers on the other side of the ball.
It's the ninth play of the drive. And he carries the ball for a nice game. So at the end of one, and this one's knotted up at three. And we welcome you back to the action here, and we have got a tight one going on in quarter number two. He scrambles. Decides to slide. How about that conversion on third down?
Good push here by the guys up front, and they are really starting to work hard in the trenches.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 13-yard line. score at the 12th play of the drive. Touchdown, Chippewa. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Central Michigan is up 7. Tackle at about the 35. The running back gets 2 on the carry. Their own 35-yard line. Second down. Now he's scrambling. And he tackles him hard at the 44. Intercepted.
You never know what'll happen when the ball ricochets like that. Good effort by the defender.
From their own 44-yard line, second down. He makes the catch and has a first down. And he's taken down right around the 36-yard line. Fights forward to about the 36. It's second and 10. Ball on the 36. Makes the grab and he's got the first. Central Michigan is up by a touchdown. He's going to try and scramble. Lost the ball. Fumble. Defense says they've got it, and they do. So can the defense match their effort from the last drive with another takeaway?
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
On the ground, left side. He gets to about the 24-yard line.
That makes it second and 2.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. After a decent run up the gut. He's in trouble. Decides to tuck it in and he's got space. Knocked out of bounds at the 38. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and 1. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 44. Good outside run there.
They got a few yards there, but they need to be thinking bigger right now.
They'll bring him down at the 38-yard line.
Good job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
From the 38-yard line, first down. Here's the play action. Fires end zone. And for Dixon, he makes it 100 yards worth of catches.
If you can get open and hold on to the passes, chances are you're going to have a good game. And that's exactly what this guy's been able to do today.
And there's still a lot of ball game to play, fellas.
I was really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same strategy here.
Give to the running back, and he's going to lose yardage. The D lineman wasn't letting anyone by him that time.
Yeah, the big fella did a heck of a job plugging up the hole where that play was supposed to go.
Second down, 13 yards to go. All on the 37-yard line. Central Michigan up 7 points. And he's tackled around the 42-yard line. Central Michigan's out of timeouts. There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Now he tries to buy some time. He's going to air it long. It's going the other way. We've got a great game here, folks, as we reach the end of the first half. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. They'll work the left side. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. Picked up a yard of anything on that run.
With the safeties coming up making plays near the line of scrimmage, that tells your offense they've got to start throwing the ball to keep them honest.
He gets out to about the 28-yard line. That makes it 3rd and 7. It's 3rd and 7. Ball on their own 28. It out to his receiver in a hurry, and they make the stop at the 41-yard line. That makes it 1st and 10. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. They bring him down.
Brad, not only did they give up a sack here, but their quarterback just got hit and hit hard. If I'm an offensive coordinator, especially an offensive line coach, I'm getting a hold of my offensive line, making sure these guys are on the same page, and they've got to take more pride in taking care of their quarterback than that play right there.
That was incomplete, and it looked exactly like their last pass.
It was the exact same play, and I think the offensive coordinator just tried to pull a fast one.
3rd and long here, and they hope to convert another one and keep this drive going. 5 wide. Going long. And he's got it. Spectacular play. And now it's 1st and goal. Now first and goal with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Central Michigan is up a score. Touchdown, Central Michigan. So he punches it into the end zone for the second time today.
When Heisman voters are trying to decide who will get their support, they're going to be thinking about performances. The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
He takes it right side for a good game. Second and five. Ball on their own 30. Nice run up the middle. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. He's taken down right around the 16-yard line. Central Michigan is up 7. And they get nice yardage on that run.
First and 5. Basement. Defense.
So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. First and goal from the 4, looking for Pater. Down, Chippewas. He's been a force getting to pay dirt 3 times.
You know, if you didn't have this guy on your Heisman list yet, in this game. The last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
Nice run, and he's brought down.
That'll make it 2nd and 7.
From their own 35-yard line, 2nd down. The 35-yard line. Quick out to his receiver. And for Dixon, he's got a very real shot at becoming the new single-season receiving yardage record holder.
You can throw it deep or dump it off to him at the line. He just knows how to make a play, and he's made a bunch of them this season.
We've got a 1st and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. He sails it long. Got it to the senior. The 10. He's all the way. Touchdown. And for Dixon, he's set a new NCAA record for receiving yards in a season.
Well, he's definitely earned that spot in the record books. He's such a constant nuisance for the defense, and many times, they don't have an answer for him.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Makes it to the 34. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. He tops 100 yards on the ground with that last run.
This kid is just a monster when it comes to picking up stats. And I'm sure the folks who vote on the Heisman will take notice of that.
He's at midfield. He's tackled at the 48. First and 10, ball on the 48. Scrambling around. Slings it. Brought down at the 44-yard line. Him hard at the 30. From the 30-yard line, it's first down. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. The middle for a nice run.
That makes it second and six.
It's second down, 6 yards to go. Ball on the 13. And a quick throw. Touchdown. See this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
Tackle made right around the 32-yard line. From their own 32-yard line, it's second down. Central Michigan is winning big. Carries the ball for a nice game.
That'll bring up third and six.
Fires out to his receiver. Tackle at about the 45.
I like this wide receiver a lot. He knows where he needs to be on the field so the quarterback can get him the ball. He made a terrific play to keep this drive alive.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. He makes it to the 45-yard line. At left side. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. So we're looking at another third down here.
Three down,
incomplete. One of his receiver.
That was textbook coverage by the defense. That's a pass play, but it doesn't always happen.
The offense comes back out, and as I'm sure you'll remember, their last possession ended in a lost fumble.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
Second down and nine to go. Ball on the 40. In the shotgun and five wideouts. Quick strike and he drops it.
Hey, Brad, I really don't understand what the offense is doing. Correct me if I'm wrong, but they have the lead and we're late in the game and they're still throwing the football. And I understand sometimes you want to try to rub it into your opponent's face, but here they're stopping the clock and giving the other team a chance to get the ball back.
He heaves it to the end zone.
That's exactly how they drew it up in the sidelines.
And that should do it. Our final tally in this one. Central Michigan, 45. Kent, 24. So what are your final thoughts on this one, Kirk?
Central Michigan started this season with one thing on their mind, playing here for this trophy. And now that they're the MAC champions, nothing feels better than reaching a goal you strive for all season long. Congratulations.
For the Chippewas, they remain undefeated. And for the Golden Flashes, this loss will put a damper on what's been a great year.
Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. It's an often heard refrain across college football. You'll hear players say, "We want to win this one for our seniors." Two excellent groups of seniors tonight. One of them will get the ultimate prize, a national championship. Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming up next with Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I will see you at halftime.
National championship game will be played in Pasadena. Let's head down to the coin toss down. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. And down he goes at about the 27-yard line. Central Michigan's feeling pretty good about themselves right now. Record-breaking performance a week ago, that's great, but they got to put that in the rearview mirror and get back to work today. From their own 27-yard line, second down. The safety with the interception. Breaks one. Inside the 30. And he's taken down at the 21.
Well, the quarterback should have thrown that one out of bounds. There was just no room to get.
I'm sure the quarterback would love to make amends for that last pick.
It may be early, but don't think the coaches haven't spent a lot of time reminding these guys how important it is to take care of the football.
Passes to the wide out, and he can't pull it in.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith in your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 25. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. Central Michigan's got a guy behind center that can really do it all, Herbie. I mean, he's a dual threat. He can hurt you with his feet and his arm. With this guy, it's PYP. Pick your poison. Receiver and he can't hang on.
Not a very impressive set of downs. Quarterback just doesn't seem to be throwing.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. That's a great tackle at the 24. Great job by the running back, and that's a gain of 9. Second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. And he's tackled around the 39-yard line.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
First down. First down grab. They'll bring him down at the 45-yard line. That makes it from the 41-yard line. It's second down. And he is drilled at the 40-yard line. Richardson only picks up about a yard there on the option.
That was a good reaction to the blitzing linebacker. That's what you'd like to see out of a young quarterback. He just has to ignore the pressure and get the ball out of there on time.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. This is the eighth play of this drive. And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five-wide set. He's in trouble. Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 19. Scrambles. He might not be able to get the pass off. Room around the corner. Tackle at the 22.
You know, great effort here by the ball carrier, but I think they need the pass.
It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one. Side after a nice pickup.
That makes it second and six.
From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. Fires quickly to the fullback. He's tackled at the 32-yard line.
Number 28 makes the tackle at the 32-yard line. That makes it third and three.
The middle for a nice game. Both teams getting closer to the championship as we wrap up the first quarter. The score, 14-0, Alabama. To the action now here in the second quarter. Run left side, and they make the stop at the 38. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 38. And they got him.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Passes it, and it's picked out of the sky. He's taken down at the 29-yard line. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Well, we've got a new man calling signals now. Let's see if he can do any better than the starter. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. He chucks it downfield. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up, and something good may just happen.
He lets it fly. No, incomplete. The defense forced a turnover on downs on the last drive.
Let's see if this offense can reestablish some confidence after being stopped on downs the last time they were out on the field.
Nice run there as they work the outside. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Fires it out. He's got an opening. And he's finally shoved out at the 31-yard line. And that's the way you're supposed to play pitch and catch.
Absolutely. You know, this wide receiver is a difference maker. He's one of those players that has a chance to go the distance every time you get him the ball.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry.
This receiving corps runs some great routes, and that last play was an example of that. As a defender, it can be tough to match up sometimes.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 18. They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield. For his man, Well, he tried to thread the needle with that pass.
Well, here the quarterback makes a poor decision throwing into coverage. Needs to look at his progression and find the second and third receiver.
From the 20-yard line, it's third down. Fires out to his wideout. Touchdown, Chippewas. So the kicker's going to stay on the sidelines. These guys will try for a two-point conversion. They're crowding the line. They go on the ground and fail on the two-point conversion. So a six-play, 75-yard drive. After failing on the two-point conversion.
I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. And I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning where they start to get a little bit fatigued.
That makes it second and 10.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. He's to the 40. Brought down around the 42-yard line.
Hey, watch the left.
makes the catch, and he might take it. And he's finally out of bounds at the 29. First and 10, ball on the 29. And he hits him hard at the 16-yard line. He's getting awfully close now to the school's single-season passing record.
It's been a terrific campaign for this young man from day one. Breaking that record would be quite an honor.
He gets out to about the 15-yard line. We've got a second and 9 here. Ball on the 15. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. That'll bring up 3rd and 4.
They've got tight right, tight right.
Three down, three down.
And on the throw, he caught it. Touchdown, Central Michigan. And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it 2 touchdowns and 2 possessions.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator's got to be livid. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
It's 2nd down, 6 to go. Ball on the 42. Once and all, going deep.
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception only to be dropped.
Quick out to his receiver. And down he goes at the 44-yard line.
I'm not even sure if this young quarterback even noticed that both middle linebackers were rushing towards him. He is so poised. And he knows he's got receivers who can make plays.
He throws left. And got him! And he scores! Touchdown! He's just broken the school's record for passing yards in a season.
He's taken apart every secondary they've faced, and now he's got this great achievement to show for it.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And they'll get him in the backfield. So it's 2nd and 12. Ball on the 27-yard line. Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's all the way. Touchdown. So now the offense comes back out, hoping for the same success they had on their last drive.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now, it's really paying off.
And he's finally brought down at the 49. First and 10 following that big run. He's at the 40, has it to the senior. And he's taken down at the 39. Tight end, right. He's at the 30. Makes it out to about the 26. From the 26-yard line, first down. He tackles him for a loss. Tackles him hard at the 16. From the 16-yard line, first down. Fumble! And they fall on the loose ball. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
If the defense had been able to fall on that, we could be looking at a big shift in momentum.
And he makes it out to about the 11-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. Tackled at the 1-yard line. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Everybody bunched up tight defensively. And he's level at the 1. That brings him second and goal. And this is the 10th play of the drive.
Keep it up, defense. Keep it up, guys. My game.
Touchdown, Chippewas. Pretty good looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there. To the 30. He's to the 40. And he's shoved out of bounds around the 46-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46. Great display of offense by both teams so far. As we head to the fourth, Alabama's lead is a touchdown. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Caught, and this is going to be a first down. And they finally knock him out at the 22-yard line. It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Richardson only gets about a yard there on the option keeper.
You have to like how this linebacker was able to move up quickly and bring down the ball carrier for a short gain. Nice stop by the junior.
Quick throw, almost intercepted. They're really fortunate that wasn't intercepted.
Not a very smart decision by the quarterback. He had no shot at completing it.
Pretty obvious passing down here as they're faced with third and long. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked. Just about ready to call the first play of this drive. They were able to pick up a field goal on their last possession.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 24-yard line. Rolls right. He's tackled right around the 32-yard line. He's to the 40. Tackled right around the 46-yard line.
Boy, how about the poise? This kid wasn't worried about the blitz at all. Both middle linebackers were coming, and he stayed calm and delivered the football for a new set of downs.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. He throws right. Incomplete. Almost picked off. He's on the run. They'll bring him down to the 38-yard line. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. He's scrambling. Slides down to the ground. Making 100 yards rushing for him.
They say that the truly great players step up on the biggest stage, and they don't get any bigger than this.
It's second and 8. Ball on the 31-yard line. Fires to the wideout. First down. He's taken down right around the 16-yard line. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Scrambling around. Tackle made at about the 5-yard line. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
He's got a nose for the end zone. What more can you say? He wasn't giving up on that run until he was in for the score.
They got to him early, but didn't get quite enough of him. And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the 2-point conversion. He's in for the conversion. So with just over 3 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, the score is Alabama 48, Central Michigan 45. Central Michigan is ready to kick it away. He just drilled this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. I have a feeling we haven't seen the end of the fireworks today.
Brad, with this offense having the lead, you know they're going to work some clock. You know they're probably going to be conservative. It's a good opportunity for this defense to take some chances, bend their ears back, try to get aggressive, and try to get the football back.
Got the corner. Knocked out of bounds at the 44. Here we are late in the fourth quarter, and this is what this game has come down to. Every possession is going to count, and this could be the one right here. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Rune around the corner. He goes out of bounds at the 36. From their own 36-yard line, it's first down. Oh, he had a shot at the pick. Third and long here in the fourth, and this is the biggest third down of the ball game. He's under pressure. Room around the corner. Well, that's just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Inside the 30, and they make the stop right around the 24-yard line. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. He's going to try and scramble. He passes it. And it's incomplete. They tried to fool him by running the same play again.
Yeah, fooled no one there, Brad.
From the 24-yard line, it's second down. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. This is the eighth play of this drive. Throws it in a hurry. They've done it. I can't believe it. And he converts the extra point. Well, folks, do you think we can see another Cal Stanford? They need to return this all the way to win it. He's to the 20. He's pushed out of bounds around the 33-yard line. Central Michigan is the national champion. As we take a look at the highlights, Kirk, how would you summarize the action in this one?
Central Michigan made the journey and finished it off with the national championship. It really couldn't have happened to a better bunch of kids in a classier school than this. They've battled all year. Whenever it got tough, they came together and came out on top. And now they're on top of the polls, the world, everything. Congratulations to our national champion.
And for Dixon, he'll walk out of here with the Player of the Game Award. For Alabama, they drop only their third game of the year, making their record 11-3.